Good morning, class. Our word for today is causation. I was never a big fan of lectures in college, mostly because of the sheer size of the classes and lack of personal attention. My freshman econ class had a bigger population than my hometown. Happily, it's just us here today. Rather than bore you with a dictionary definition of causation, let me just briefly explain it like this. When I began selling cars, I was intent on changing the perception shoppers had of sales consultants, so I tried to be nice to people and give them everything they asked for. Test drives, prices, trade-in values, everything. And guess what? It didn't help. I learned that customers didn't particularly care for car salespeople, not because we were nasty to them, but rather because we didn't take the time to get to know them. I had assigned an incorrect causation to the problem. Today I'm going to show you how to learn more about your customers so you can use that insight not to sell them, but to help them buy. So stick around. I'm Jon Quade, the 5-Minute Coach. In-person sales interactions are always about relationships, and it's up to you to take the lead with your customers. Sometimes it's challenging because of what I mentioned a minute ago. Shoppers often enter the sales process with preconceived notions. Here's how to combat that. Begin by asking questions to gain insight, to build rapport, and to lead the conversation. You will never learn anything about your clients by telling. You only learn by asking questions. I'll give you some question examples in just a few moments. Building rapport will help you create a business friendship by picking up clues as customers answer your questions. For example, if a client mentions that one of their kids, Aaron, plays hockey, you can ask linking questions. Here's how it sounds. Oh, great! Our son played center and forward all through high school. How has Aaron been doing? Because you're asking the questions, you're the ones leading the conversation, which you should be as a sales professional. Next, make your vehicles fit your customers, not the other way around. Here's what I mean by that. I have watched thousands of sales interactions, and I often see salespeople showing customers a vehicle, seriously, within a minute of their arrival at the dealership. At that point, what does the consultant know about the customer? Answer, nothing. So when they're showing the vehicle, they're just describing it, not knowing if what they're saying has any relevance or any importance to the shopper. In essence, trying to make the customer fit the vehicle. Instead, the salesperson should first ask questions. Hey, I'll be happy to show you the truck, but so I don't waste your time on something that won't work for you, let me just ask you a couple of questions, okay? Get the idea? If there are multiple people in the party of customers, be sure to direct your questions to everyone. The one person you ignore, grandpa or even a young child, may be the one who ultimately influences the decision. My wife and I are building a house, and we're choosing appliances and windows and shingles and lighting and plumbing fixtures. Woohoo! We stopped at a lighting store a few weeks ago and met a sales consultant who didn't bother to ask us a single question about what we wanted or needed. She kept saying, "I love this fan, and this fixture is my favorite." Look, lady, and she was very nice, if you're not paying for the house, you don't get a vote. All she had to do was ask us questions about the styles we like, any statement pieces we had in mind, and where we might be inclined to save some money. Then she could have related everything she showed us back to our answers. Ta-da! We would have had a personalized sales presentation instead of one that was focused on her. So, ask questions, including linking questions. 2, create a business friendship by building rapport. 3, make your vehicles fit your customers. And four, relate what you learn back to your client's answers. Okay, as promised, before we go, here are some vehicle-based questions you can ask to learn more about your customers. Here's the first one. What are you driving now? Has it treated you well? What would you like to be different on your new one? Here's another one. How do you typically use the vehicle? Do you commute? Do you often carry passengers or take trips? Then, what one or two things are most important to you in a vehicle? Safety, performance, comfort, styling, what? By understanding the reason for the questions and having some ready to go before you ever meet a client, you'll be in a much better position to help your customers find the right vehicle. And that's it for this episode of the 5-Minute Coach. I'm Jon Quade.